This video is to show you how to use CSS to style a table. In previous videos, I gave the table a width and I centered it. I gave it borders, but I took those away, so now we just have a very simple table that looks like this. I did keep the background color for the T-head and the T-foot, but that's just about it. So let's take a look at some of the things you can do to style your table. First, we want to give the table a width. So right now, the width of the table is set purely by the amount of text that is inside each of the columns. If we put in more text, then we will get, at the widest areas, then we will get more width to the entire table, like this. So that's not how we want the table to be sized. We want it to have a width that we choose. So let's go into the table, and let's say width, and let's make it 800 pixels. And by doing that, we now have a width that is much closer to what we want. We can also center it just as we can with block elements. The table is not exactly a normal block element, but it acts very much the same way. So we can say margin auto, and when we do that, the table will be centered in the page. Now let's take a look at borders. If you put a border around the whole table, what'll happen is that you'll get only that border. So I'm going to put 1 pixel, solid, and let's say gray. And that border will only appear outside the entire table. Notice that there are no borders now between the rows and the columns. If you want that to happen, you have to go to the TD, not the table row, but the table cells. And you need to give them a border. And let's make this 1 pixel, solid, and black. And then you'll get all of the different, the outlines or the borders for the table cells. Notice that the TH didn't get it because I didn't give the TH that kind of a style. But if I add TH, then those will get their borders as well. There we go. Next, we're going to do background colors. Now, the background colors can be applied to the table, the TR, or the TD and the TH. This is how they work. If I put a background color into the table itself, let's go here, and let's give it an RGB. And let's call that RGB, let's say 190, 170, and 100. So this will be kind of like a median tan. And say save. So now you'll see that it fills up all the available spaces, not only in the cells, but also between the cells, right in there. So that's the entire background for everywhere in the table. Notice that we have different background colors here because in those cases, we made the table row background for the T-head and the T-foot different. Now, there is no background color for the T-body rows. Therefore, those stay blank and they just show the background color for the whole table. But if you put in a background color for rows, then that'll override what's in the entire table. So let's do that. Let's make another background color for the T-body, TR, and that'll be the rest of them. And let's make that one, background color. And let's just make it white. There we go. And so now all of those are white, even though the background color for the table is a darker color. But let's say I'd like not the first name, last name, not the headers, but the data cells to have a lighter tan or beige color. So what I would do for that is that I would say inside the T-body, for the TDs, not the THs, I'm going to put in a different background color, and that's going to be RGB, and let's make that one, 230, and then 215, and then 190, and let's save that. And now when I reload, you'll see that now these ones have a different color. They don't affect the THs right up here, but they will affect the individual cells inside the T bodies that are TDs. So here you can see that the TD background color, or the TH background color, will override everything else. Next, you have the TR background colors, which will override the table background. And then behind everything else, you've got the table background color. So there's that. Next, we want to do text align. This right here, my wonderful table in the T head, that's not centered. So I'd like everything inside the T head centered. Now I could center it inside the TR or inside the TD. Since I already have a TR, I'm going to center it here. I'm going to say text align, and I'm going to say center. And that should center my text in that row. I could have done it for the TD, but you can do it for the TR as well. You can do the same thing for the font style. For example, if I say, font family, and if I make the font impact and sans serif, and then I make the font size, let's say make it a 24 point, that will also affect the text in that row. So I could do that again using the TR or the TD. You can format text, anything having to do with text, in either the table, the TR, or the TD, depending on where it is and how many places you want it to have affected by that. All right, next let's take a look at padding. If I add padding to my table, then that'll be different from adding it to the table cell. So I'm going to add a 30 pixel padding to the table. And now you can see that I have padding all around the edge of the table. Now, if I have padding inside the TDs, so I'm going to go to the TD and the TH in this case, and I'm going to add padding there, and I'm going to say padding will be 10 pixels there. That's quite a bit. Now you'll see that it affects everything else. It affects all the TDs and all the THs. Notice that the spacing between the cells is not affected. There's a special style for that. We'll get to it in a little while. Now, another thing that I can do is that I can affect the width of certain things. For example, let's say I want my TDs to be a certain width. Well, what I can do is that I can say I've got four different columns here, and so I could make each one, let's say, 25%. So I'm going to go in there, I'm going to say TD and TH, and I'm going to say width, and that's going to be 25% of the total. That'll make all of the columns, all of the TDs and THs, the exact same width. And there we go. So now everything is width, has about the same width. Now you'll notice that when I did this, Ponta's Hobby, Sleeping, Eating, and Playing, went on two lines. And you'll notice that in most of these cells, the cell height is actually fairly large, but everything is kind of centered right there. Like Pontevedra is centered. It could be higher up there. You'll see that Sleeping, Eating, and Playing is higher up. This is further accentuated if I say that the height of every single cell will be taller. I can make it, let's say, 60 px, and let's see how that affects it. Now you can see that everything is much taller. I've given a height to every single cell, and that makes it much bigger. But you'll notice that everything is centered right in the middle. What if I wanted to start at the top left and then go down from there? Well, what I could do is that I could give it a vertical align. Now this is something that usually will only work in a table cell. So I'm going to put it right here and I'm going to say vertical align, and I'm going to make it go from the top to the bottom. When I do that, everything should align more at the top of the cells rather than along the middle. So you see Pontevedra and Luis are now at the same height from the top, but now Sleeping, Eating, and Playing goes down from there. So vertical align is something that you could use. to make the data go from the top to the bottom of each cell. We can also place background images. I wanted to make the cells bigger before I put a background image in there. So let's go in to the THs. I'm going to make a separate style for the TH. And I'm going to give that a background image. There we go. I'm going to say URL, and I'm going to use my images folder. And I have an image in there called paper.jpg. I believe it's JPEG. We'll find out. And now if I save it and reload, now you'll see I have a background image in my THs. The image will repeat from the top left of every cell, although I could put the background image in the TR instead of the TH. But in this case, I just wanted to affect that those table headers right there. So you can also do background images, not just background colors. One more thing I'd like to show you before I end this is how to get rid or increase the space between the cells. Now, in order to show this, I really should get rid of the padding. So I'm going to take away the padding from the table. I'm going to take away the extra padding from the cells. And now my table looks like this. It's more of a normal table. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the table style. This can only be done in the table. I can't do it in the TH or the TD or the TR. And I'm going to first put more space between each cell. And so I'm going to use border spacing. And I'm going to say, let's say 10 pixels. Now, 2 pixels is the default. So if you put 2 pixels, it's going to look exactly the same. 1 pixel will look thinner, and anything more than 2 will look wider, just like that. So that's how you can create extra spacing between the cells. But in most tables, you don't want to have any spacing between the cells. So there's a different thing you can use for that. It is it cannot be used with border spacing. So you have to use one or the other. But this one is called border collapse. And the value is simply collapse. And when you do that, then this happens. You lose all of the spacing between the cells. Notice now we cannot see the background color of the table itself, because nothing of the table is showing. Only the cells are showing, and the cells, of course, are in table rows. Now, this doesn't look too good because I've got the table cells being too tall. So let's make that height, let's say 30 instead of 60. There we go. And my text is a little bit too close to the edge there, so I do want to add some padding. But I only want to add padding on the top and bottom. So I'm going to say for the TD and TH, I'm going to create padding, but I'm going to create none of it at the top and bottom. I'm just going to create it at the left and the right. I'm going to put 10 pixels padding on the left and the right. And there we go. All right. So that's how you style a table with standard CSS.